I have like no sense of direction in real life, let alone trying to keep track of like text-based maps that you can't see. It's just sick.
I love it. Okay, that looks great. And then we gotta fix our text here, properties. And we say, Orion, are you feeling okay?
I'm fine.
Motion sick is the toughest part with those first person games.
Yeah.
That's
You
Orion
said
Trial.
trial, which
That's
is
Orion
wrong.
Trial. I
Oh, it
saw it.
could be.
The Orion Trial.
It's not fun, it's a trial, right? If you don't enjoy it, I don't know. Orion trial sounds trail sounds cute. Rich was showing me Oregon Trail.
Oregon Trail, yep. Oregon Trail is pretty good. Orion is a
Little
Orion
bit
Trail was a
different.
lot of fun. It was a lot of, come on over here. All right, we'll do that and then zoop.
They used to let us play Oregon Trail after our
The
regular lessons in our little computer class
chat,
on our
the Stanley Parable
Apple IIs or
experiment just
whatever.
ended. It just It
ended.
just ended. It was a resounding success of an experiment.
Confirm the hypothesis.
Confirm the hypothesis. Update.
Did I hear about the aliens in Elite Dangerous? No, I did not.
Someone found aliens in Elite Dangerous.
Like, found them.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I don't know if that, I don't know what that means.
Play
I'll be quite
options,
honest with
credits,
you.
and
Could you
exit
hand that to
game.
Rich, please?
I could.
Thank you. I don't know if that means anything because I don't know much about Elite Dangerous.
Right.
All right. Hey everyone, let's get to some tips.
All right, we did the first zone.
Yep.
Here's the second zone. All right, we already did Janaya Leeway.
Yeah. Well, and what we've discovered is you need a whole new crew for every zone, which is kind of BS.
Yeah. Oregon, well, there's an Oregon Trail, or Oregon, I guess, is how some people say that state, but there's also a game called Oregon Trail, which has zombies, like organs and tissues.
Oh yeah.
Right, what do we want? I want to stay away from Captain Janeway because we did her last time. So we got attack and science, or we got science and diplomacy.
Ooh, you know what? Like, look at that captain. Like, one, I would love a bear for a captain because
Yeah.
that's funny.
Were these ever characters in any of the Star Treks?
This
I don't.
isn't official. Like,
Oh,
this
it's
is.
Janeway Leeway. It's not Captain Janeway.
Yes. But Captain Forever does look fairly rad. So, I
Oh,
mean, this is
Captain
a.
Forever.
Okay,
It's
great. Look at that.
name. Chat name.
Chat name?
How we picking this?
Hop over to the random the
We went to
randomizer.
the randomizer?
Sure. I mean, we got
Ah!
it.
You stupid.
We got the randomizer. Got to use it. We'll and do for the captain, do subs only.
Chat lottery. Subs only? All right. For
Subs.
the captain, subs only.
Subs only, and mods, of
And
course.
mods. Cool Cat Saves the Kids. Have you heard of that? Purple Space Bazooka. I have heard of that. I don't remember what it was.
Purple Space Bazooka. You are now the captain.
Take the keyboard. Can you type for me?
Yeah.
Excuse sliding in my.
Get a slightly more comfortable position here.
Right, first officer. So we got
First officer.
diplomacy and science. What do we want
So yeah, we already have diplomacy and science. We need someone with a oh.
to? Yeah, I know. None of these are great. This is like a jack of all trades here for like Cubilus.
So is Don. Don Thacker's got us a little bit of all of the stuff we need. He's got
Yeah.
bravado, he's got tactics, and he's got attack. That ticks us one in every box, then.
So,
I say Don
you
Thacker.
say Don Thacker? All right.
Look at that guy.
Did people have different abilities in Oregon Trail? It's been so long since I played it. Hit.
Oregon Trail?
What do you want me to hit?
I don't
Wait,
think so.
nothing. I'll hit the thing I need to hit.
All right, now put everybody.
Everybody?
Everybody. Subscribers, moderators, and non-subscribers. Randomizo.
Dots 85!
Dots
Dots
85
85.
is our first officer. Man, I love that randomizer. Thank you so much, Leftover Beefcake. That makes it so much
No,
easier.
that's right. The shift, one of the shift keys on this thing doesn't work.
Captain Butt.
Okay. Want to accept? Yeah. All right. Now we got Hanna-Barbera character.
Colonel Bananas, and Sigvei Rinn.
Ooh.
All right. We have a lot of tactics.
A lot of tactics. That could be great.
A little bit of bravado, a little bit of science. Yeah.
Hey, Yonder says, hey, assholes, I was here early, but you assholes weren't. What gives? Were you oxygenating your womb space? I want my damn money back.
For what?
I don't know. And Yonder also says, speaking of awesomeness, XCOM 2 is on Humble Bundle this month for 12, you fucks. That's a great deal for XCOM 2. That is a great deal.
Blue Dog?
Yeah, all right. Humble's got a bunch of stuff this month that look like it would be stuff
Humble's great.
That Rich should be interested in.
Humble's
and you,
great.
Potentially. I think you guys have, there's a lot of overlap between your
interests and yours. Are we doing everyone again?
Do we only get three?
Four.
Okay, do everyone again for this one.
And then the last one?
Yeah, the next one. Just subs.
All right. French Wookie! can you remember that?
Yeah.
French Wookie.
Like
you
that.
Knew I did.
You know
I
what?
Did
that's
want,
close enough.
I did want Spengy because I like the girls, but hey, that's not my. It's not my choice.
Chat want a blue dog. I want a blue dog.
Absolutely.
All right. Do we want to min max a bit? Get some really high tactics. Get some really high diplomacy.
We'll need something. We have no attack.
Then we just avoid attacking.
Right.
None of these have attack anyway. That's not an option. It's just not an option.
So you might as well just like get the max number of something.
Sean.
Well, we got either max.
Easily is his name backwards.
Let's go with Yusilabnaze.
Yusilabnaze?
Bit backspace. And this is going to be subs only.
Pick a rando.
M-Tilt. E-M-Tilt, right? Am I reading that right?
E-M-Tilt. Yes, M-Tilt.
You want the exclamation point?
I think those come. Those are.
If you can, whatever. Oh no. Okay.
Those,
yeah.
Those aren't part of the.
Yeah. Game. That's right, because you can't have a space.
Right.
All
right.
M Tilt, you're on the team.
Boom.
We got to get there. From here.
We're there. We're here.
The maps get a little bit more complex, by the way.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh fun.
So what do we want? What do we want? We want to go heavy on food, fuel, hull. Or do we want a little bit of everything?
You know.
By the way, here's what the dog bearer looks like.
I'm watching What's-Her-Face banging on the keys.
Right?
And this is our captain with the helmet.
Oh,
the,
I love that.
The pigtails.
Swinging his leg.
These people are great. Those little animations kind of make it.
Oh, they do. They're adorable.
Adorable.
All right, so what are we going with? What are we going with?
I say Even Steven. Obviously, we'll need
Even Steven?
Food. No. I like Even Steven. I'm a fan of Even Steven.
All right, we're going Even Steven.
Recruit More Pimps for You says, will we see a half in the bag prereq crossover episode regarding Assassin's Creed?
No.
Probably not. No one's mentioned anything.
I care so much about the video game movies.
I am curious.
Especially when they're games I don't care that much about.
Right. I know, like, the first Assassin's Creed's all right. I hear the movie's pretty terrible, which I think is why they wanted us to do it, because people like it when we shit on movies. P.S. Steve from Stranger Things is in a band called Post Animal, and they're playing in Milwaukee on Monday at the Cactus Club. Which one's Steve?
Isn't it like the preppy...
That was the preppy kid?
The preppy boyfriend.
Oh, yeah.
He's playing at the Cactus Club.
Preppy boyfriend?
On Hopefully Monday.
Hopefully he doesn't have that kind of mullety thing going.
Or maybe he keeps it. Just so people recognize him.
Who wants to narrate?
Oh, so I'll do this one. We'll take turns.
Okay.
Boom, boom, boom. HR reports that all your unpaid internships have expired. Interns made up most of the crew, and without them, the ship will go dark. Worse, no one will bring you your morning coffee. They are about to leave by shuttle. How do you respond?
So what are we going with?
Throw a fake
career fair.
Yeah.
Do all the jobs yourself.
Or automate their jobs.
Well, We don't have much bravado.
Bravado.
We got good tactics, and we got okay science.
So tactics. I mean, if we're just going numbers, we go tactics, right?
Yeah. Are we just going numbers?
But if we go science, does that question box mean that we could like earn something?
We earn the plus. We earn crew. Right. Minus, we might lose fuel.
Right.
Plus, the box is a random plus. We don't know what.
It could be anything.
It could be anything.
Oh, okay.
This will get us crew. It might lose us fuel.
Yeah, let's go with that one.
That one?
Yeah, why not? Also, don't ask me to be strategical, Rich. You're the one who...
You announce over comms that the Indestructible 2 will be hosting a job fair to help the departing interns know their future opportunities. Little do they know, the only career showcased will be the very low-paying one right here.
Dun, dun, dun! Engage! Yeah, we won! One thing! I had no idea my options were so limited, one intern says as he flips through the pamphlets. It's a good thing we had this job fair to contract my horizons. Dreams thoroughly crushed. All the interns returned to work.
Yes.
Plus 4 crew. Moving on.
GameChild UK says, are there any plans for you guys and Mike to do a video about the new Star Trek series once it premieres? Very interested to hear your thoughts on it after it premieres. Also, will you stream Resident Evil 7? Possibly stream Resident Evil 7. Anything's possible. Probably not anything official on the new Star Trek series. We'll probably watch it.
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Like, you know, who knows?
Ren, you want to read it?
Well, Jack's turn, but sensors indicate that there is some sort of floating memorial nearby. Your navigator asks if you want to make the short detour to check it out.
Yeah, let's play our respects. It's fine. Captain Duck Dodges! He was warned not to try and seduce the Queen of the Arachnoids. He was unfortunately successful.
That's nice. Oh.
I like it.
You begin giving a powerful, impromptu speech about its meaning. Halfway through, you sneeze and interrupt your train of thought. Huh.
Moving on.
Apparently, all of the gravestones were Kickstarter rewards.
Ah!
You've been boarded. Oh, great. It's inebriated Galactic Mooch, the Kapalka. Hey, Captain, let's get this party starting. I'm super hungry. What's for dinner? Oh, wait. Let's go to Kepler Burger and...
All right. Sigh. Offer him a snack.
Ugh. Lure him into the fuel vats.
Hey, the Keplaka got your invite.
So what are we going with? What are we going with?
All of them give us fuel.
It's comic book guy and Jabba the Hutt.
For min-maxing, we're going with blue.
Well, and you know what? Also, we have the most fuel to burn in case we lose, and that one loses.
Well, I don't think these things are all relative to them. You know, the numbers. You lose, like, more fuel than you do food, you know, for instance.
Oh, right.
You explain to the Kalpaka that the party is down on the engine deck. You're hoping his species dissolves in starship fuel. Oh, and that it won't hurt him. Actually, you're not too worried about that.
Massive win! No, not massive win. Win it all. Win it all is good.
I turned down Rich's microphone.
Partway in the engine. Doot, doot, doot.
Usually wise.
The Kapalka sings, screams as he plods down to the fuel stores. Plasma cannonball! With a splash, the fuel begins to violently churn and then turn a deep purple. You've supercharged your fuel!
Boom!
Alright, food.
Boom.
Or random.
Buster Load says, hey, three people! If you guys didn't do what you do now, whatever that is, what other professions might you pursue? Also, have you guys ever pooped standing up? Started doing it a month ago, and it's great.
You spot unexpected passengers aboard, taking holographic pictures and asking impertinent questions of your crew. They claim to be fans from another dimension where you, your ship, crew, and perils are viewed as popular entertainment. I have never pooped standing up.
Have you ever peeped standing up?
Not in a toilet.
Where? Where have you peeped standing up?
we talking about this? Is this the thing we're discussing live in front of people?
No, like when I was a kid, we had a pool, and if you had to go pee instead of running inside, we'd do it like underneath the pool deck. Like,
oh, okay.
You know, sure. In your clothes, right. And then use the hose to clean ourselves off.
Sure.
The garden hose.
You know what I saw a commercial for the other day? Is a little stool that you put your feet up on whilst pooping.
I've seen
so,
that.
So it's that like your
so
feet
you squat.
So your feet. So like you're in more of a squatting position, which is apparently like how you know cavemen pooped. That's how our bodies are built.
In Indian people or we're Chinese supposed
to,
people.
Right. Well, it's how
people who don't do the toilet.
People who don't have a toilet. Like that's how our bodies are built to poop. Like in a squatting position.
That's what I hear.
So it's a tiny little stool that you put your feet up on. I thought to myself, I got kids. I got a bunch of stools in my bathroom. So like I pooped with my feet up on a stool.
And how was that?
I don't really notice a difference, but yeah. Like they say it's better for you.
You know, they make like rubber things so that women can supposedly like, if you're traveling or something that you could supposedly just hold this over yourself and it directs things. But I haven't tried any appliances.
But like, if I'm at home, like I'll still, you know, put my feet up. And I get like maybe it works better. I don't know.
You can try different positions, you know. Put your feet up on the bathtub. See how that works.
The squatty.
Put your feet behind your ears if you're real flexible.
I'm working on it.
Are we doing diplomacy?
Leftover beefcake. You are absolutely right. A bidet is life changing. If no one has a bidet, they're super cheap. You can install them really easy. Washes your butt. It's the greatest thing.
I need a bidet.
It's the greatest thing.
How cheap are they?
I mean, you can get it for like $20 on Amazon.
$20?
Do these like fit into a regular toilet?
They fit into regular toilets. They're not the fancy ones are the heated ones. The $20 ones won't heat up the water, so it's cold butt or cold water.
Where's
going
the water
into your
coming
butt?
From?
From
the tank, I hope.
Not from the tank. From the thing that fills the tank.
Okay, but it's not like coming from the bowl.
No,
like
it's not coming from the bowl.
Yeah, that would be counterproductive.
Yourself and, you
it's
know.
Coming from the supply, and it, like it's super easy to hook up. Hooks right up to any toilet, and it is goddamn life changing.
But then you still need to use paper to dry everything off, or do you have like? Don't they have ones that like dry you or something?
Oh yeah, but those are like the fancy like $800 ones. But you know what?
The fanny fan.
You use significantly less paper to dry. Then you do like normal wiping. It's great. It's the greatest thing.
Just imagining our numbers going down.
People are interested in down, bidets.
Down, down. So right, what are we doing?
What bodily function do we want to talk about next?
Bidets. I could bidet for days.
How about neti pots?
I'm going to examine them and their gear.
You can stick one of those. Have you tried one of those? I haven't tried one yet, but I hear you stick it in one nostril and it blasts your snot right out the other nostril.
Would it surprise you to find out that I have used a neti pot before?
Would not surprise me a bit.
They're horrible.
Are they?
Oh my God, I hate it.
Wait, what is this?
You've never seen a neti pot?
It's a thing that you stick in one nostril and use it to shoot stuff out of your other nostril.
It looks like a genie lamp.
Yeah.
And you, I need to
and
do
it gives your brain
I'll
amoebas in worst case scenarios, I hear. You've got one?
Well, I don't have one with me.
Oh.
So it looks like a genie lamp. And you fill it with water and a saline solution, and then you put it in one nostril. You put the tip of the genie lamp, and then you go like this, Rich. You go. And the water goes up one nostril and out the other nostril. And it's just like, and you look like a psycho person. As it,
this
like,
this sounds horrible.
It sounds horrible.
It's supposed to be good if you're like congested, though, or something, or allergic or something. Might be good for your allergies.
It cleans your nose like nobody's business. It feels awful, but it cleans your nose like nobody's business.
Does it feel like when you get water up your nose in the pool?
Yes. Lisa used one a lot when she was pregnant because like when you're pregnant, you have to be like very careful about like what medication you take. And so she was super concerned about that, but her nose was super stuffed up. So she started using it and she loved it. So she got me a neti pot. I used it once and said, fuck that. It's weird. I'll just blow my nose, and I don't get.
But Lisa liked it.
Lisa loves it.
Transdimensional travel may prove useful to you.
Transdimension, like Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Yes.
Transsexual to Transylvania.
Exactly like that. You order the science teams to carefully scan and observe the fans for how they accomplish this.
That's right. It's an enema for your face.
Since they seem distracted by every little detail of the ship, you think you may get away with it.
Well, people usually use enemas in their butt to clean things out before procedures. I don't even want to know what you're cleaning your nose out for.
We failed.
Lobotomy?
These fans have no idea what they're doing. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
You know, you've all been talking about snot.
Yeah, you're better at it.
Snot and poop, bro. Go ahead.
This whole thing was that it was an added value experience they bought tickets for at SpaceCon. You've wasted valuable resources. A stern letter to SpaceCon is in order.
That was bad. Oh, that was really bad. Ooh.
Asteroids.
Listen, snot is where the conversation went, and we took care of it. We took care of the conversation. You're welcome. We're talking about all the important stuff here, like snot.
Suddenly, your ship slows. You have some parasailers attached to the ship's back bumper, screaming with happy abandon. They're a thrill-seeking race of extreme space sports enthusiasts known as the Parkouri. Get rid of them, or suggest a parkour duel. Plus crew, minus hull, plus random, minus crew. Eh, we're okay on hull. Let's do the random. Simple enough. If Galaxy Force wins, the Parkouri will have to leave the Indestructible 2 alone. The Parkouri win. You'll make them an extreme trophy.
Whoa.
No. Maybe. No. 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 Wait. Oh, wait. Ow!
Whoa.
Booyah! Oh, go.
Righteous! Team Galaxy Force wins! The Admiral's so impressed he sends the team on an interstellar promotional tour to give demonstrations at schools! Huh, they're gonna be gone a while!
Minus six crew.
You only have 22.
Wow.
Darkwing Schnuck says, here's a $2 tip for Shunte and the Pirate Curse on Humble Bundle. It's $1, I think. It's the best of Shunte and the predecessor to Half Genie Hero.
Did you guys just buy that last week?
Half Genie Hero?
No, yeah. Shunte.
We played that a bit.
Yeah.
You played that a bit, I saw. How'd you like it? I was looking forward to that.
It's cute. You can like beat people with your hair.
Yeah, it looks great.
It's a platformer.
It looked great.
I like it.
Did you play that off of my account or your account? I might have bought it.
I think we bought it on mine.
Oh, okay.
So, hungry and curious, you dock at the Warp Junction Bazaar, promising goods so foreign you'll swear they are theoretical. You approach a cart loaded with glowing vegetables, ready to get what you want. Propose a friendly cooking contest. Ask about price matching. And examine the vegetable closely. We got good tactics. We just lost two in a row. We're going with the blue. We're going with the goddamn blue.
You deviously question whether or not the vendor will match the very low price you just recently saw in a nearby system for alien vegetables. Much more glittery than these.
Damn. Calling them out.
Oh! Critical fail! Critical!
Shit.
Oh, no!
The vendor calls your bluff, politely asking to be shown where to find these lower prices. Oh. Wrapped up in your lie, you agree. Ooh. After a three-day journey, you finally drop your foolhardy long con, and sheepishly take the vendor back to the bazaar.
Look at what we lost. Two bravado.
Yeah.
And 200 fuel.
Ooh.
Holy.
Out of how many?
360.
Fuck.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Oh. Purple Space Bazooka, you are a horrible captain. Purple Space Bazooka.
Len Flakazinski says, watched Fury Road for the 50th time. All three heroes have an arc. Furiosa learns not to run from her problems. Nux cares for the heroes.
You receive a message from a nearby mining colony inviting you to stop by to trade resources.
I was like, right in the fucking middle of a tip.
Sorry.
It's like, someone paid us money and wanted to hear something.
and it was right in the middle.
I apologize to whoever it is. I seriously. Sincerely. My bad.
It's fine.
It was funny, so it's okay.
Okay, that makes it all right.
All right, now let me finish this time. All three heroes have an arc.
You receive a message.
I saw you. I saw you provoke her. Richard Edlund Evans. All
from a nearby mining colony.
You guys are terrible. All three heroes have an arc. Furiosa learns not to run from her problems. Nux cares for the hero, and Max conquers his flashbacks. I also saw La La Land and loved it. That is the end of the tip now. I'm really looking forward to seeing La La Land.
We almost saw that, or didn't we not? We went to the movies. And
I asked what it was Christmas. About. You said, I think it has something to do with Los Angeles. And then we look, and I said, well, I've been wanting to see that Maori or whatever it is one. The Disney one with the Polynesian folks.
The Queen of Moari.
It is. It's gotten great reviews, mm-hmm. and it looks pretty. So I'm like, well, I've been wanting to see that. And so we went to the theater on Christmas Day, and then we realized that the only seats available were in the front row, and we decided to skip it.
Gotta get that app. The Marcus app.
Then we could have paid online, but I don't think that way yet. I'm not used to that. My brain hasn't acclimated to this glorious future we live in.
I guess we just didn't think it would be that busy on Christmas Day, but it was.
Yeah. It's a good idea.
It's a great idea.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And I love the Dreamliner seats. And I hear some places have them heated now.
Ooh, damn.
You need to have, like, vibrating
ones. Basically, they're
ones
just asking for people to take a nap. I'm like, come on.
Oh, God, yeah. But I have that problem with theaters in general, just because, you know, you're in a dark place and still. You receive a message from a nearby mining colony inviting you to stop by to trade resources. They seem friendly enough.
All right. We just got low HP, so let's chat with the locals.
You wander the cramped halls of the mining colony until you come upon something resembling a general store and a bar. An elderly grobulin leans against its stall. Bored.
Resources.
I'll sell you some people for food. Where'd you get all that food? Where'd my people go? But La La Land is a musical. It's a musical starring Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone. It is set in Los Angeles.
What's it about?
Two beautiful people in Los Angeles, I assume. I have no idea.
A love story?
I don't care. It's two beautiful people singing in L.A., so it's like, it's going to be great. Okay. That's all I know. That's all I know about it, and I've heard some good things.
You finish your dealings with the grobulin and take a look around. The bar still seems to be open.
Wait, I'm being stupid. More important, I have hole.
Looks like you're in the yellow and 3 out of 4 squares, rectangles.
It's not looking great. That's not looking great. Not looking great.
You take a look around. The bar is packed with lively characters from all around the sector. Who would you like to talk to? One of the miners or the bartender?
Or you could head back.
Which one?
Oh, have a chat with one of the miners. We already talked to the bartender.
Miners are sitting around enjoying their time off. After introducing yourself and chatting for a while, it's clear that these guys are pretty short-staffed and undersupplied.
So are we.
Science or diplomacy? But we'd be trading something.
Something, yeah. Well, either one. Doesn't matter. They're horse apiece.
The miners are willing to give you some data on some of their more unusual ore in exchange for some hull planning to reinforce their shuttles. They could always use more helping hands, too.
Mm. We'll do it. I'm doing it.
The miners thank you for the extra help and transfer the agreed-upon
stuff to your data pad. Sorry.
You return to the hub. The general store is still open, but the bar appears to be closed. That's backwards. Bars are usually open later than regular stores.
All right.
All right. Time to leave. Time to leave.
Moving on up. Evil Lord David says, hey, guys. David jumping in. Stool poops are good for older people. I like to call them stool-stools.
You mean poop-stools?
Poop-stools, yeah. Like,
I need a little bit of everything, so.
Whoa.
Uh-oh!
Sensors indicate that there is some sort of floating memorial nearby. Your navigator asks if you want to make the short detour to check it out. Will you pay your respects or stay the course?
Pay your respects.
Cheryl Plotts, firmly planted in the ground. That's nice.
One of your officers tackles you and knocks you to the ground. A swinging blade trap clangs harmlessly above the gravestone. Hey, plus tactics.
Nice.
All right, so we're gaining stats, but we're fucked on supplies.
Drat,
you've entered fancy space. Hopefully you can pass through without anyone...
Ha ha ha, what do we have here? What have we here, a Galaxy Force cruiser? How droll. Prepare to be boarded by the great Raculot for your extravagance evaluation.
Deploy the gaudy goggles! Flatter Raculot to distract him. Escort Raculot to your private quarters. We're gonna deploy the gaudy goggles.
Do it. Deploy. Your chief inventor is honored that you remembered the gaudy goggles. He presents them to you, explaining that if Raculot wears them on his tour, he will see the most magnificent ship imaginable.
Oh, wow. Okay, good.
With the gaudy goggles in place, Raculot sees a whole different ship. Your ship is astounding, Captain. Follow me to my distant homeworld, and we can discuss upgrades. Distant was an understatement. You burn a lot of fuel, but it was worth it.
So low on fuel.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
So low on fuel. Oh, no. Random item or crew? We're low on everything. We're low on crew?
Critically low on food and fuel.
Right. Moldy Nutri-Paste! According to your head chef, a batch of Nutri-Paste has become infected with a strain of fluvian mold, rendering it completely inedible. However, if you expose the effective paste with some high-energy radiation, that'll kill the mold. Dump the food or belt it with the... Oh,
your fuel
no.
situation's even worse than your food situation.
Right. dump the food. Yep. Yeah. Oh, that's just 15. We can deal with that. Oh, God.
I know. Operation Innovation. Your manufacturing robot, MK421, has constructed an exact copy of herself. She informs you that she has lots of ideas and wants to make more friends. This makes you a little uneasy. Her green eyes blink at you, awaiting your orders. Ask her to build a giant friend. Ooh. Offer her full use of the lab, or build me an army.
We probably have, like, we have the most hull to lose, so you almost want to say build me an army.
We're gonna lose that one almost for sure, though.
Well, maybe.
We're going with science. Grateful. I shall relocate to the laboratory. Your chief scientist isn't too sure about this, but you don't care. You want to see what this robot can do.
Okay.
All right, we won. All right. We won. That was the point. We got it. We did it. We did the thing. MK421 is ready to present the fruits of her labor. Optimistic, I present to you a squad of nonviolent holographic crew members. They are projected by small mobile rovers that scuttle across the floor. I call them...
Humbas.
Oh.
I get it. No, I get it.
Pun is good.
Dots 85 says, here's $15, five for each of you. For talking about crap, for talking about snot, for interrupting tips because I'm slightly drunk, and of course for general awesomeness. LOL, have a nice evening.
Aw.
So, you know, these are snot and poop is something that happens in everyday life.
And nobody wants to talk about it.
But everyone should. You know why? Like, pooping is important. And having nice, regular poops is super important for everyone.
Who's reading?
You pick up a broadcast as you pass a nearby warrior world. All are invited to prove their worth in the fields of glory and win fabulous prizes. Food, fame, lifelong friendships, death. You stroke your chin and consider the proposition.
Yes, assemble the away team. Oh, who's leading the away team? I'm going with French Wookie.
Sure.
I don't know.
Works for me.
He's got plenty of tactics.
Tactics, the high number is good.
Yeah.
Unless, hey, I can be outvoted.
Unless there's no the thing I'm worried about is that there's no tactics option. And then he's only got one science and the shit hand everywhere else. Dots has one of many things. I mean, French Wookie's the smart is the math bet. French Wookie. But Dots might have a game to play here.
So you're saying Dots.
I'm saying I might go Dots.
I'll say M Tilt. He's kind of in between the two.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Now we're a 3-way tie and that helps nobody.
I'll go with Jack.
You go with Jack? All right, Dots. It's the wrong choice, I told you. It's the wrong choice.
Also, I've told you not to listen to me because this is a strategy game and this is your forte. I know. And
this
you
is
keep
also
listening to me.
Look, if I just do the smart thing all the time, that's no fun.
Sometimes you want to do the Jack thing.
Right? Your away team arrives in front of the Colosseum. Banners proudly displaying various home planets wave in the breeze. There is a buzz of excitement in the air. Your team of champions awaits your orders.
Begin the game and find some food.
On second thought, get out of here.
We'll find the food.
Your team sets off to find some hopefully edible street food in the midst of the revelry.
Moving on.
Your team arrives at a small cluster of food carts, each offering a different style of food. Unfortunately, all of the signs are in languages that currently don't exist in the Galaxy Force database. Your away team looks to you for orders.
Oh, there's a blue option. If only I had the guy with the high blue stat. Oh well. On we go. On we go.
Yeah, a little bit of everything.
Is that thing?
It's all. You know what? It's all a dice roll.
Alive? Right?
It's all a dice roll.
Dots 85 is handed a wriggling, multi-legged creature and chokes back a gag. All right.
That's fine.
That's pretty tasty. Everyone on the team eats one. Moments later, a larger version of the creature bursts from Daniel Harrison's chest. When the food shipment arrives, you make sure to put a warning label on it.
Warning.
Got us some food. You're welcome.
Your team returns to the front of the Colosseum. Banners proudly displaying their home planet wave in the breeze. There is a buzz of entitlement in the air. Or excitement in the air. Your team of champions await your orders.
Begin the challenge! Team proudly marches into the arena ready to prove the awesomeness of Galaxy Force. Team enters a large open arena. Some kind of large elephant centaur towers above them menacingly, wielding a tree trunk in its trunk. Anyway, it's really big and scary. Dots 85 looks to you for guidance.
Oh man, there's no tactics option here. It's a really good thing that this guy, our guy, has some stats of other stuff.
He had a science stat too. We could use the science.
He had one science stat.
He's got one of everything.
That's what I'm saying.
He's got one attack stat. He's got one tactic stat. He's got one problem.
Which means, by the way, if he does a really good job on this, you could probably build up his stats a little bit, which would help you in future missions. Don't you think? That'd be great.
Dots 85 spits into their hands and rubs them together, still deciding if this is actually a good idea. Oh, this won't be good. This won't be good. This won't be good.
Come on.
Oh! Epic win! Epic win!
Boom! Building up stats!
Dots 85 runs spryly along a wall and leaps onto the creature's back, and then shooting it at its other back, you know, the one with the arms and the head. Anyway, It tumbles to the ground lifeless. The crowd goes nuts!
Moving on.
Your team returns to the front of the Colosseum and recuperates, readying themselves for the next challenge.
Curious to see what's next, your away team re-enters the arena. Test of intelligence.
Your team enters a gigantic labyrinth filled with what you can safely assume are dastardly traps and monsters. With no clear path forward, Dots 85 requests some orders.
Just start walking, navigate it legitimately, or activate X-ray vision, which I don't recommend.
Just start walking, motherfucker.
Just start walking?
Just start walking.
I'm walking. Ooh. Yes, indeed, I'm walking.
Okay.
Oi. Oi.
Dots 85 sets off in a northerly direction and hums contentedly. They see the exit, sadly. The humming seems to have attracted comically large ants, and Albert von Fancy Pants is hauled off to meet the queen.
Oh, no.
Your team returns to the front of the Colosseum, readying themselves for the third and final challenge.
Dun, dun, dun.
Let's finish this. The away team marches into the Colosseum one last time. What could that final challenge be?
Mountains of what appear to be ice cream line the arena. Weirder still, there doesn't seem to be an obvious opponent. The aliens in the stands watch breathlessly. What are your orders?
Melted.
Dots 85 sighs heavily and sets their phaser to party pooper.
Oh! Shoot! Wow! Fuck! Zap! The ice cream melts. Realizing the new danger they're in, the team zaps a hole in the nearby wall and the sticky soup surges out of the arena. Dots 85 tries not to think about the sugary hell outside.
Your team faced the challenges of the arena and prevailed. The master of the arena calls Dots 85 forward and demands to know what they seek as reward.
Food, fame, or lifelong friendship?
Oh, you could definitely use some food.
Food's never a bad thing.
What's fame gonna get?
Bravado?
Food's gonna get supplies. We can get supplies elsewhere.
Lifelong friendship is probably diplomacy.
Probably, well.
And fame is bravado?
Ooh. Maybe. Lifelong friendship is either diplomacy or more crew members.
Ooh.
Fame is almost certainly more bravado.
Possibly?
Right?
This is all up to you.
Chat?
We do need more crew.
Chat, what are we going with? Food, fame, or friendship? Fuel isn't an option. Food, fame, or friendship?
Friendship, food. Friendship is magical.
I see two friendship, one food.
We stick together. Friendship,
this isn't,
harmony.
This isn't Ponylandia.
Friends forever.
Magicalia. Where are they from? I can't remember.
Together.
Friendship, friend. I see three friendship. Friendship, is
friendship.
Magic. We're going two fames. It's close.
Friendship is magic, Rich. That's what the My Little Ponies taught me.
Yeah, where are they from? Is that Ponylandia? It's
I've seen a lot of friendships. Hysteria. Lifelong friendship. Oh, that's not bad. I'll take that. That solves our crew problem.
And our food problem.
Yummy.
A single tear rolls down the arena master's face. I, too, know the pit of despair that is loneliness. You shall never go wanting for friends again. 16 crew, 60 food. No stat gains, which is sad.
We got two critical wins.
Yep. Yeah, well, this is a pretty good haul.
That's pretty good.
Well, with a critical win, you don't lose a crew member.
Right.
Each of those people that die, you could lose a person.
Sure. Okay.
When it lands on one of the other
is
blue ones,
is that red
it's not
shirt
critical.
In the front, Peter Griffin?
Yes, I'm going to say yes, because why not? Moving on. Now we desperately, desperately need fuel. Random. Food. We're okay-ish on food. I'm going to try the asteroid belt.
Unit 603 Idiot says, "Hey, Rich and Jake. I broke my leg on New Year's, so I'm laid up and out of work. You haven't played an adventure game in a while and would really appreciate it if you could do one soon."
Monitor, you clearly asked the text to build you a robotic hall monitor. Run for your lives!
Funny.
This man is talking about his suffering.
Jack, I wasn't
and Rich funny. Is just I interrupting.
Know. It wasn't funny that time. He's I tried talking, and I failed.
He's talking about his agony, and you are just
trying to be
you
a
don't
jerk.
Care.
The joke's old, Rich. You we did it I once, know. And it was a good bit.
I know.
And now you gotta, and
I
you
tried
to go back
too many
to
times,
the bit.
And it failed.
Unit 603, and it ends with LOL, poop is funny.
That was just fine. The, it was, you were
that
at the end.
It. That was at the end.
So what's the whole thing?
But squatting is impossible, unless it's
he wants us to play. They want us to play more adventure games. This okay. is kind of adventure.
This is good enough. This is, you know what? This is ish. Adventure game ish.
Yeah.
It's fine.
The Admiral hails you, but it's an unusual call. He's not at his desk. There's a weird echo, and you hear strange noises. Then you hear a toilet flush. The Admiral is hailing you from the bathroom. This is going to be awkward. Do you call him out? Politely ask him to not stand up? Or hang up, laugh it off, and forget it.
Which are we going with?
I mean, it's all the same. I say we call him out.
I think it'd be more amusing. Perhaps if you let the Admiral know you recognize where he's calling from, he'll understand for himself that this was inappropriate of him.
Absolutely. Absolutely inappropriate.
You can't unhear those noises.
No. Yep. Yeah.
The Admiral gets defensive and angry. How dare you accuse me? Another toilet flushes. He hangs his head and sighs, unable to keep the ruse up any longer. I'll be taking some of your fuel to not write you up for insubordination.
Well, look at this.
Oh.
What's that say?
Minus 150.
Yeah. What's our current fuel?
Negative 140 now.
Well, you can't go negative fuel. We just have no fuel.
Out of fuel.
Engage SOS. Da 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 dee 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 da 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 dee 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 SOS. And Len Fleck has since guessed all that.
And what happens? A large fancy ship approaches. And you are hailed by a woman in a power suit. She explains that she's a recruiter, looking for new talent for various job postings around the quadrant. She's willing to give you fuel for some talent.
Yeah.
You exchange a tearful goodbye with the crew you send over, hoping that they enjoy their new jobs. Once you receive the fuel and part ways, you realize that she may have been a slave trader.
Did you just sell your new friends as slaves?
Some of them.
You're so excited. The last time you were at Omega Mart, you invested in a state-of-the-art efficiency management machine, the TFS 9000 Efficinator. After months of waiting, it's finally here. You can't wait to try out all its functions. So will you read the manual first?
Yeah, we're going to read the manual.
I mean, that's just a good idea in general. We also have the best stats.
You'd rather know exactly what you're dealing with before you install your new TFS 9000 Efficinator.
Right.
I'll take it. The machine in the box isn't the TFS 9000 at all.
What?
Darn those restocking associates at Omega Mart. They offer a complimentary case of Martian Dream Nutri-Paste.
Ooh.
Terrible tasting, but hey, it's free.
Ooh. You got an achievement.
That's great. That's just great. Tanning Bedlam. You awaken to find your tanning bed seems to have died on you. The fact that you don't have to sleep in your sunglasses is a meager consolation. Minus one bravado.
What?
Bravado. I know, I can't say words. We all know this. Leave me alone.
You've arrived at the Space Alamo, a popular trading hub for the taco shans, as well as a variety of other local species. The chili people seem to run a tight ship around here, so it should be pretty safe to stop for a spell.
Wait. The only person that needs to heal is one.
Ooh, 30 food is too much.
Yeah. No, and the only one of your guys is
well, I, you know, if it were cheap, it would have been worth it. The Space Alamo is renowned for its orbitally grown produce, but there also seems to be a bar, along with a few other traders in the vicinity as well. Resources! We need... Get rid of that hole. We need...
We're not doing anything with that stupid hull.
Ugh.
This is a tough run right here, Rich.
I know. I'm good with that.
With trade complete, you head back to the center of the market. You take a look around. It's packed with lively characters from all around the sector. Who would you like to talk to? The lady with the power armor? The guy with the table full of gadgets?
Lady with the power armor.
Let's return to the market.
Power armor?
Power armor.
All right. All right.
You approach the woman in power armor, who introduces herself as a bounty hunter. After shooting the space breeze, she lets you know that for a price, she'll be happy to improve your ship's offensive or defensive capabilities. I mean, we got shit attack points.
And we'll have slightly less shit attack points that are still shit.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah?
What do you think? What do you think? What's going on? What would you, what would Rich Evans do? Because that is the correct decision.
Guns.
Don't listen to me when it comes to strategy.
I like guns.
All right, I'll go with guns.
Yet he keeps doing it. He keeps listening to me.
I know, what an idiot. Because
he has the mouse. He can do whatever he wants.
Oh, God. Two whole plates. Oh, God, fine. Oh, two whole plates.
Well, you didn't have to
let's
do
just
it.
Be massively fucked.
Why did you do
just
that?
Massively fucked. You know, I'm fine with that.
Why would you do that?
I'm fine with being massively fucked.
That would be several massive. Why did you get up your hull points?
I know I should have added a tactic so it's overpowered. But it's a group effort.
No.
And if I'm too smart, it's not as fun.
Well, no, you win the game and we keep talking about poop and snot and shit. It's
that's
great.
Exactly why I have to not play so good at the game. Food or food?
We could talk about, sweat or whatever fluids we have in vomit.
After an hour of looking, no one can find the hourly productivity report. That should make drafting the next one easier, at least. Minus one tactics.
No, at least you got that attack. Don't worry.
Galaxy Force has received a distress call from a crew filming a nature documentary on the third planet of the Akarit system. They're trapped, and you're the closest ship. Away team to the rescue! We're going with the dog! Dog is going this time.
You like going doggy style with the characters here.
You want to be careful about what you say. You want to be careful.
Out of context?
Out of context.
Out of context.
Gotta be fair.
What the hell?
Out of context. My nice microphone stand isn't working, so I have a handheld microphone stand here.
That you just dropped on the keyboard?
That just fell.
The humanity?
It fell on the keyboard. Fartlord 69969, I won't be reading that tip. We appreciate the tip, though.
Okay.
We're trying not to get political.
Empty shuttle pod. The away team approaches the source of the distress call and find that empty
really
shuttle
it.
Completely overwhelmed with warp
we really
weasels.
The
oh, no. Not warp
it's
weasels.
Very important to the show.
They're eating the padding on the chairs, chewing exposed wiring, and building nests everywhere.
Are they nuclear weasels?
Wessels? Weasels?
Weasels?
I get it.
Nuclear
I get it.
Weasels?
Search the area, because we brought a guy with good tactics.
You spend watching the show. Try to do a job making the show. Thank you again. Nice.
Turns out the film crew is helpful.
Helpfully left a trail of breadcrumbs behind to lead right to them. As a bonus, the away team has now collected some bread.
Great! I'll take it! The film crew, it turns out, is filming a short distance away. As the team approaches, the director motions to be quiet. They're filming a giant Akiri wild beast rooting for food. It's stunning. Until French Wooski sneezes. Study the wildebeest.
Study it.
I'm Lunchy. I'm here. I'm just off of the web camera. I'm directly to the left of the webcam. But I'm just here. We're just here having a good time. Karen needed to be on camera because the stream started with an experiment.
You can sit here next to Rich, and I'll sit there.
I think it's more important that I'm over here. I started the night over here. And I'm thinking about leaving in a little bit. I'm feeling kind of tired.
All right. The wildebeest, as it turns out, is quite a ham. As soon as it realizes it has cameras pointed at it, it begins to strut and pose and pout. Stog Weiss realizes their true calling as an animal photographer and leaves the crew. Yep. Why'd they turn into a pile of ash?
He found the film crew and dealt with a rare Akiri wildebeest. The crew asked for protection as they finished filming the episode. There are several cool locations they could film next. Which one is your away team most prepared to handle? That cave. Always the same cave.
We'll go to the cave. The film crew is feeling bold. Now that they have the protection of a Galaxy Force squad, they suggest filming at a cave. A little ways north, you see no reason why not. Your away team is armed and dangerous.
They said that they have trouble hearing you now, Jack.
I know, I'm talking quietly on purpose. It's my bit now.
Okay.
Okay.
No one cares.
The away team and the film crew tentatively explore the cave. Parlon Merkins. Really? What? Merkins?
Merkins?
Oh, no.
Parlon Merkins, the host, hopes they'll get actual footage of Akiri bats. No sooner does he say that than a whole flock of the spindle-legged, seven-eyed brutes swoop down. Duck!
Franchuki yells for everyone to get down. The bats will fly overhead and out of the cave, and the danger will be gone. Brilliant! I love their little...
Wilhelm?
Just about.
It is.
Is it a straight-up
That's a Wilhelm.
Everyone ducks, and the bats fly overhead and out of the cave. Unfortunately, Scott Dannon Rushford ends up face down in a puddle and drowns.
The Hirono says, "Hey guys, bam! Hope this video aids."
The away team collects.
No, I'm sorry.
Couldn't resist.
It was a nice try.
Couldn't resist.
Both of you are meanies and poopoo heads. AIDS in your quest for a TV. It's a quick buying guide aimed at 4K, but also for 1080p. Also, thanks for the signed copy of Space Cop. And they included a link to a YouTube video for TV buying.
Oh, thank you.
Because Rich was talking about that the other stream. Thank you.
I bought one.
Yeah.
What?
I found a 55-inch at Target for 4K for $5.99.
Shit, dog.
What do you think of it?
I like it.
You like
it's
it?
Nice.
Okay.
What do you think of it?
I gotta play around with the settings on it to get a picture I love. I think that's important.
Did you find Auto Motion Plus?
I gotta find like all the settings. I just like this. Got this the other day.
It's got a whole pile of settings, and it's got like a bunch of special buttons for like Netflix and stuff.
Ooh, built-in web capabilities. Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
You're watching little librarians and some house cards.
The away team collects itself from that harrowing experience, only to come upon a rival film crew also filming a nature documentary. It's the Splat Brothers. Those loud edutainment guys in their khaki shorts. Uh-oh. Invoke maritime law.
The rules are clear. When on an unclaimed planet, maritime space laws apply, and that means these Splat Brothers are invading the wild Space Kingdom crew's territory. You order French Wookie to explain this.
As far as what model of TV? Vizio 4K.
Hey!
Blue. I can't give you like a serial number off the top of my head.
Oh, he's got some good... Here's some good advice. Turn on your 4K TV and turn the color down all the way. TV was meant to be watched in black and white.
That's how they do it in the olden times. What kind of granola do I eat to keep my bowel movements regular? No granola. Beans and a lot of green vegetables. It's got the most fiber. Keep you regular.
Sure things smell great at your house.
You could set a clock by my bowel movements.
But I won't.
Hey, Gobbledygook says, "Headache night. Trying something new. Listening to your show and imagining what you're seeing. Keep up the good work."
Thank you.
Seems like a poor choice to listen to us while having a headache. Just putting that out there.
The Splat Brothers definitely don't want to do anything illegal. They apologize and leave, telling the Wild Space Kingdom crew about a nearby orchard where the fruit is ripe.
A nearby what?
Orchard? Orchard? Whatever. You know, I don't know words. You read this. You're Mrs. Reedy Reed.
Your away team and the Wild Space Kingdom crew see a flock of stately Akiri blurts. These are large, ostrich-like birds with two heads, which were only rumored to actually exist.
All right, stalk the birds, because we have high tactics.
You order French Wookie to carefully stalk the birds, allowing the film crew to get the best possible footage for the Akiri 3 episode of Wild Space Kingdom.
Slow down, slow down, slow down. Oh.
Fine, that's fine.
No, that's good.
Fine. Jarek Kith catches the attention of the birds. Parlin Merkins offers an interesting fact-filled narration of the attack. The crew of Wild Space Kingdom has only one more species to film on Akiri 3 before they come aboard the Indestructible 2. You're now standing before the amazing and dangerous grove of giant carnivorous Venus flytrap plants.
Oh dear. Warp Weasel.
The viewers are going to want to see these awesome plants in action. Heck, so do you. You order French Wookie to throw a warp weasel into the grove just to see what happens.
Fartlord, I got your second tip.
That's a lot of potential critical fails. Oh no, oh no, oh no, 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 no. Keep going, keep going. Second wind, no.
Second wind. And a plant catches the warp weasel in its mouth, but it gets the small mammal stuck in its long, thin throat. It coughs up the warp weasel with such force that it functions kind of like a bullet when it emerges, taking out a couple of your away team. Minus two. Now that the mission is over, there's all this footage from your adventures on Akiri 3. Some of it could be pretty embarrassing to Galaxy Force. What do you order French Wookie to do with it?
All right. Commandeer or destroy?
While it could be embarrassing to Galaxy Force, you could probably sell it.
Considering that you're...
What do you think that will do in-game?
That your admiral, like shits on the phone, you know? What are the standards?
Right. I'm waiting to see what the chat thinks.
They say commandeer, commandeer.
Oh my god,
commandeer.
You never know what you might need when you might need embarrassing footage to blackmail someone with. Plus, you may recut it into a series of entertaining vines.
Oh, hey. Timely. Vines aren't a thing anymore.
Your away team, or what's left of them anyway, finally, but safely, Twitter. Return to the Indestructible 2 with the crew of Wild Space Kingdom. The Grateful Network offers your choice of reward. Yeah, probably.
Fuel!
You ask for fuel. The network obliges, filling your tank totally up. Parlin Merkins narrates the entire process.
Sorry.
Now we're putting the gas in the gas canister. We're filling up.
I clicked on a YouTube link, and it was this.
It's worse than the original version.
I love it. It's perfect. It's All Star by Smash Mouth, but every word is somebody. Hey, stop it.
I had forgotten how much I disliked Smash Mouth.
Oh my god, I fucking love that song. Thank you, Crocodile Brain, for sharing that with us.
Marlon Perkins. Rich should know that reference. He's old like me. I don't know that reference. What is that reference?
What reference?
Marlon Perkins.
Isn't there a Marlon something in the Star Trek? What's the name of that guy, that weird trader guy that sold them?
That wasn't Marlon. That was the Tribble? I don't know. I don't remember who his name was. Are you thinking of Harry Mudd though?
Yeah, probably.
That's not the Tribble guy. Alright, moving on.
Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to
see. You are so done, Jack, aren't you?
Marlon Perkins was the host of Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom.
Never shine if you don't show.
I remember that show. I remember the name of the guy.
Sensors show a vessel approaching, and all channels are jammed with a catchy tune. It's in a Megamart superstore. Galaxy Force ships can't repel bargains of this magnitude. Your crew turned to you big doe eyes. This is going to be costly. Compile a shopping list. Only what you need.
Yeah, you did it!
Was it? You zip past throngs of browsing shoppers. You deftly dodge the sales associates' tractor beams in the cosmology department. You grab all the necessities and hop into the express lane.
Whoa.
Just ahead of a Grobulan broodmother. A perfect run. 100 fuel. Nice.
A what?
A goobla gobbla gobob.
A grobulum.
Yes, Jack is bored. Jack wants to go home. I got a feeling this will be a last run tonight.
I think it's almost time.
Jack needs his bedtime.
Yeah. You can leave now and we can finish up.
Is that cool with you?
Yeah, that's cool with us.
All right, I'm going to do that.
All right, Jack, have a nice night.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for coming out.
Jack is not quite as much of a night owl as we
are. I'm not a night owl.
It's not that late. Yeah, it's fine.
Not that late for you.
Want to read the thing?
That thing?
Yeah.
You come upon a space colony. The Titanic Synapsion brain beast has mated into its nest. The colonists within are mind slaves under the beast's complete control. Besides that, the colony appears bustling and bountiful.
Adios, Jack.
Bye, everyone. Have fun space adventuring.
Bye-bye. Farewell. So long.
You look on as your science team prepares to jack into the beast's psychic mind.
We're getting fish. We gotta have you guys over sometime.
You're getting fish?
We're getting fish.
I bought an aquarium for Christmas.
Yeah. Oh, and in my head, I thought you were like saying like for to eat.
No!
Like glub, 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 you know, fresh water.
Cool.
Sensors indicate that there is some sort of floating memorial nearby. Detour. V'ger!
Expired of exhaustion from getting a 27-hour space loving from the famed giant tentacle monster of the Medusa Cascade.
I'm the only one who gets the V'ger reference. I'm the only one. You read the gravestone aloud and hear a gasp from one of the crew. You are later informed that what you said was highly offensive in Fabulon culture.
Not cool, Captain.
Okay, goodbye.
Drive carefully, it's shitty out.
V'ger was the thing in Star Trek the motion picture. The big, powerful thing. They had to stop.
It sounds like somebody's talking about Star Trek Voyager and being silly about it.
V'ger was Voyager. Not Star Trek Voyager. V'ger was the Voyager space probe. That had gotten one of the later models that scientists didn't actually launch, but it was a space probe that got sucked into like a wormhole and then ended up on a robot planet, and they souped it up, and it ended up becoming this incredibly powerful, dangerous entity.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, but it had like smuts on the side of it, so it didn't know its name was Voyager. It just saw the V and the G-E-R. It was V'ger.
Too much LDS in the 60s.
Rich, you may as well be describing what a lightsaber is to this chat. Folks know Trek. Okay. Well, Karen didn't. Karen didn't know what a V'ger was.
I know some Trek.
You were called in to handle crew drama. Apparently Tad and Alexis had been fighting. Dakota found out and made her move on Tad. Now Alexis is a mess, and Tad has threatened your transporter engineer, Skylar. Create an algorithm to solve crew drama. You don't have time for this nonsense. Craft a mathematical solution to any future crew drama. And it's not going to go well, is it? No, it's not.
The principles of logic appear to melt in the fiery crucible of your crew's cosmic drama. Nothing can be done. There is no escape from the petty jealousies that consume your vessel. Defeated, you have a snack. A really big snack.
Ow. Didn't have to be that big, did it?
Yeah. Perhaps it did. Warning, you've been targeted by a slow-moving torpedo belonging to Galaxy Force. Upon closer study, it turns out that it's one of your torpedoes, one of your previously fired volleys that must have missed and gotten its targeting scrambled.
Destroy it or recover it. We can't afford to lose hull, so we're going to lose some crew. Potentially.
It's really unusual that one of your torpedoes has managed to reacquire the Indestructible 2 as a target. It might be worth recovering it for study. You assemble a team and send them out on a shuttle.
Maybe. No? Okay, I'll take it. With sweat-covered brows, the defusal team delicately snips the red wire and disarms the bomb. Whew! When hauled back for study, it turns out this torpedo's sensors were operating during its journey, and you learn a lot about this sector. Plus one tactics! Moving on!
Is Patrick Stewart gay? I don't believe so.
Would it matter?
It wouldn't matter, but I'm pretty sure he's married to a woman, which a reduces woman? The odds.
He's married to Woman.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it wouldn't matter.
What?
You hear a strange ticking coming from the ship. You take it to the nearest repair shop, a real seedy, back-of-the-galaxy kind of place. A big lizard mechanic in overalls says it's your warp core, the most expensive part to replace.
Trick him to fix it for free!
The outer room-dwelling lizard? Please. You're smarter than this guy. You'll use your mental prowess to outwit him. Not only will he fix what's really wrong, he'll do it for free once you're finished with him.
Fine. Good. The work.
You point at the sky and yell, "Look, it's the Goodyear blimp!" Works every time. You grab a new warp core from the shelf and are out of there at warp speed before the lizard can turn around and ask, "What's a blimp?"
Plus two hull. We're doing great.
While looking for the remote to your quarters, you discover an incredibly rare Hotepulon seven-sided coin. Usually the Hotepulons destroy these on site, so you must be really lucky.
Plus one bravado! Bravado! Whatever! Fuck off! Fuck off, I don't give a shit! The same guy again!
Your communications officer says that you are being hailed by an unknown vessel floating in deep space. A shady figure appears on the holoscreen, offering repairs in exchange for some fuel.
Scan his cargo hold.
This seems to, what's the word for it? Suspicious to you. You need to know what you're dealing with here. Your science team performs a scanning sweep. Excuse my sniffling. I'm not the president-elect. I'm just getting over a cold. Oh, it's empty.
Please.
Well, that wasn't get political. Very exciting. No, but remember in the debates, he was just sniffing.
I know. It's empty.
Well, that wasn't very exciting. Awkwardly, he detected the unwelcome scan and abruptly closes the transmission in a huff. He floats idly, waiting in wait for the next ship that passes by. You leave, embarrassed.
Minus one diplomacy. It's fine. We're almost done. Actually, I think this is it.
Yay! We made it. You're forced to stop as a Takoshan cowboy herds a very large group of brightly colored, vacuum-dwelling beefalo across a busy space lane. Your navigator says it's probably safest to just wait it out.
We might run out of food. But then again, if we lose any more than five hull, we're done. I think we can deal with some starvation. Sit back and wait.
You're forced to wait for nearly 3 days as a seemingly endless line of beefalo winds its way past the crossing at the space line. Eventually, the last of the stragglers make their way across, and the Takoshan tips his 10-gallon hat your way.
Two food to spare! Not bad!
Congratulations, Purple Space Bazooka! You have successfully traversed Ursa Major in a most daring expedition. Galaxy Force honors you with the title Admirable Tactician.
Nice! You can't win without five hull? Well, you can't win with zero hole, and I didn't want to take a chance that smashing through there and damaging the ship would take out five or more hole. It was better to risk losing food and suffering a bit of starvation, which I don't think would have hurt me for that last little bit of trip. Whatever the negatives of starvation were, I was figuring we could handle that more so than the ship potentially, though not likely, getting blowed up. Losing a hull ends your game. All of your hull. Fine, this is a fun game. Not a bad stream game. Though, I think some of the encounters are going to get a bit repetitive. I don't know if there's enough. Alright, did we get any tips?
I think the Space Mouth one was the most recent one.
Okay, so they're all
ready. Smash Mouth. Huh?
We're gonna read tips. I think we're pretty much done for the night.
I think so. Subscriptions?
Yeah.
Oh, up there. Okay.
Bruce Aronick! Bruce Arons? How do you say that? How would you pronounce this?
Bruce Arink?
Bruce Arink? That's like, I like that. Bruce Arink! Are we going to switch off? Or are you just...
Ibanezist 00.
I'd say Ibanezist.
And they say, Hackbot 5000 approves this message.
Machine Gun Funk says, Groovy.
Tiny Tic Tac says, which way should I go now?
The real net boy says, cock cock or whatever, take my money, D.
Kianya.
Is Joe Flacco elite? Says, first stream I've been able to catch in a while. Here's to you guys.
Cheers. Baba Yaga Lala.
18 months in a row. Says.
You didn't read my tip last stream.
You sure?
That's what she says.
Scroll down.
Let me look.
See if you see a thing. It's touchscreen. You can just flip it up.
And that would be last time? Baba Yaga Lala?
Just keep going for a while. If you don't see anything, you don't see it. I don't know. I'm not aware of us missing one. The X135! Not safe for Wookiee! A horrible glory / S 26 fucking months in a row, says, personally, I love this stream. 8 out of 10.
Back to Baba Yaga Lala, that was, if that was the 8th of January,
first make sure it's not offensive.
No, it's not offensive, I already read it.
Okay.
Shadow of the Colossus is amazing. Do you guys know any other games with such grand scale and epicness?
Jack is the person to ask for that. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. You want to read this?
Me, Andy Nora.
Gruff McMilitary, 12 months in a row, says, at long last, the next stage of my quest is complete. I enter the elite ranks of the 12-month pre-rank subscriber club. It's been a great year, guys. Your streams and YouTube recordings have got me through many dreary days at the office.
Ren JB. Ren JB says, hey, Rich, Karen, and Jack. I just thought I'd send in my monthly reminder that Twitch Prime subscribers have to manually resubscribe every month.
Thank you. Harmon Z, 12 months in a row, says 1 year? Oh, God. Though really, who am I kidding? You folks are great. LOL, fake my news.
Striker121 has subscribed for 20 fucking months in a row. 20 months? Where'd they go? 20 months? I don't know. Thank you, guys, for many moons of almost cost-free entertainment. XXOO.
Thank you. Vice Versa Man says, I have resubscribed for... reasons.
Bradle 23.
Nerve 2112 says, R.I.P. Ahmad Abad Dud.
A bad dude?
I'm a bad dude. It's from a Police Quest game.
Being Unreal.
Chikamoo-moo!
Half Matt, half Cat. Half Matt, half Cat says, 4 months with the biggest gaming hack frauds there are. Cheers!
Clone 2727 says, might be time for a new FTL run.
Titus84 says, 4 months, what am I doing with my life?
Tadaxp! 24 fucking months in a row. Oh, you want, we'll do it again. Tadaxp! 24
fucking.
Oh, you started reading like the rest. That wasn't the fucking. I don't know. We'll try one more time. Tadaxp! 24 fucking months in a row says, the last 2 years have been the hardest of my life, but in the beginning and middle of many trying weeks, PRL was there to cheer me up. Thank you. You're welcome, Tadaxp.
Glad to hear it. Sonic V8.
You are my fire!
Lindsay Yo-Yo-Yo.
Chernobyl Kinsman 21 fucking months in a row says, Happy New Year, cunts.
Mantequillas.
And nobody else. Thank you for subscribing. We really appreciate it. This is where you say it's
We really
it's
do. True.
Okay. That's good work.
It's true.
Good night.